Alright guys, so we run a 5 gallon two cycle mix, whatever you want to consider it. We just go through so much two cycle that it made sense for us to hop up from the 2.5 gallon shirt can to the 5 gallon. Good morning, everyone. Feels good to be back from Kentucky.
Good morning.
I'm not gonna lie. I'd have took a few more days in Kentucky. Mainly, we go to this breakfast place every year called.
Don't tell them.
Why?
Because then we won't be able to get in as easy as we do.
Oh, Tiki said I couldn't tell you about Highland Mornings. It's really good.
You cannot go wrong there. Like, the breakfast there is so good.
Yeah, Highland Mornings, guys, they have two locations. We always go to the smaller one. They have these apple things. What do you guys call them? I don't get them.
Dutch apple pie little waffles.
Yep.
They're superb.
They are. I always take a bite of TQ's, but I can't handle all that sugar. So, anyways, this customer called. They have a huge meeting coming up here this week, and they asked us to get it cleaned up as best as possible. They don't typically really push the whole fall cleanups, but they asked us to go ahead and get it cleaned up as much as possible, so that's what we're gonna do. So we're gonna start with some blowing. That's always the best part to start with, right? And then, blowing and mowing, but we're gonna be blowing and bagging on the front at least, so. So if you didn't catch the live the other day, and you were going to the EWIP EXPO for a BR1000. You didn't get that once again this year. I don't know what Steele's doing. Dropping the ball there for sure. Focused on battery stuff. So if battery stuff's your thing, Steele's got you covered for sure anymore. Not my cup of tea. We'll keep rocking the old petrol. And trust me when I say this, not running the battery stuff is not the best for an influencer right now, especially on YouTube, because they all want battery stuff. So that's where the big bucks are. So if you see them rocking the battery stuff, they're getting the big bucks. Those need taken care of, but they don't have us do them, they do them themselves. All right, always start with blowing out the tough areas around the building, trees, any of that good stuff. The good thing is with this one is we can actually get rid of them out back, so we don't gotta take anything with us. Got the majority from up around the building here. Now we're gonna go ahead and mow it out, stripe it out, make it look real good. We'll be right back. All right, guys, let's take a look at it. TQ is going to blow it off. Good. These are still falling. I think we ended up taking 6 bags off. So not too bad for probably a solid couple acre lot. A little extra work this morning having to do the leaf cleanup. Actually had pretty good growth on it in a week. We'll see how it goes now since we know we got that freeze the other morning. Should slow it down quite a bit. I believe we did a good morning. Did we do a good morning, TQ?
We did do a good morning.
I don't know.
Tell you what, this hoodie's about to come off.
Yeah, it heated up real quick. Heated up.
Warming.
Heated up.
Warming up.
Warming up, yeah. Anyways, good morning if I didn't do it earlier or TQ didn't do it. I feel like I maybe...
We did do it.
I did it differently. Anyways, it's going to be a beautiful day here. I believe we're supposed to get back up close to 80 this week. Insane.
For the better part of the week, and then it's going to drop down into the 50s again. But
so we didn't know it, but I guess we got some sleet in our area last week. Early in the morning, I'm not sure if exactly our area specifically, but some folks reached out and they were like, hey, we know you got a freeze, but we actually got some sleet. So, that could have been all kinds of bad.
Good thing nobody needed any salting services while we were gone.
Yeah, I ain't gonna lie, that's not gonna happen at the moment. I mean, don't get me wrong. We can make something happen with some buckets and...
Salt shaker.
We got plenty of salt. To keep my shadow out of it. Looks good, looks good.
think he's trying to hit me with the mushrooms.
Went ahead and pulled some weeds. Nice thing to do is you can just throw them right in the bags real quick. So if you're wondering, this place that we just mowed right here, about 6 acres that we mowed this week. It's well over 120 acres total that we do at different parts of the year. For example, back there is about 4 acres. We'll get to that next week for its final mow. We mow that roughly 8 times a year, 6 to 8 times. It's hard to do one handed. There we go, got it. So, Thor Grandstand Multiforce. Went ahead and bagged it off. Look at this baby. Looks like TQ's about got the trimming wrapped up there. What is it? October? I'm not even sure what it is. Third week of October, roughly. Can't beat this. Already had our first freeze. So it looks like TQ's just got right inside that fence there still to go. Wasn't a ton of growth on the trimming this week, so she's moved through it really quickly. But as you can still see, there's some getting spotty. It'll be really slowing down. She's just got to go to that corner back there by that yellow Jeep. I'm going to get that mower, get the backpack. I'll get my backpack, the 800. I like something a little bit bigger. TQ likes that 600 still. Get it cleaned off.
Looks real good.
Yeah, it does. It's getting warm.
Yeah.
Let's move on. Figured I'd share with you guys because been getting a ton of messages from folks worried about going into this winter, how they can make extra money. Maybe they didn't have as good of a season as they thought they would, and they're just wondering how they're gonna get through the season to get till next spring. And what I wanna say, guys, is you gotta take pride out the window. Let TQ pass here. You gotta take pride and throw it out the window. Nobody's gonna consider you a failure if you need to go get a part-time job or even a full-time job to get through late fall, winter, and then early spring. You can't worry about what other people are gonna say or do. You gotta worry about you and where you know you need to be to continue growing your business, because not everybody can do snow, and I know in a lot of areas it does really slow down. What most people won't tell you is there's times in your business it's gonna suck and you're gonna be financially hurting, or you know, kind of just getting by, and that's okay as well. It's all part of it. I've been there. It's all documented from 2013, you know, till present day. You can look back. I mean, I was a big boy. I had rusted pickup trucks, but I didn't care because all the money I was saving, I was reinvesting back into the business at the proper time. And I still think to this day, that's why Spencer Lawn Care was so successful, because I was willing to literally eat crap for so many years. Now I will say, I think I did that probably a year and a half too long. So what I mean in saying I did it for a little too long is I did not take out any credit whatsoever, guys. I refused. I wanted no credit because I had the mentality when I first started that, hey, if it failed, I at least didn't want to have my family and myself in a financial situation that we couldn't get out of. So I refused to finance anything. And I mean anything. Long story short, the business started doing really well in 2015. That was when I finally decided, hey, we need to get a commercial grade mower. And that's when we bought the Skag Cheetah. I think it was $11,300 out the door, and that was a big step and a big learning curve, I'll say it as well, because we had the time cutter before that, which I paid cash for, $4,400 with the bagger. But I did that 3 or 4 years before that because I needed to be able to bag in fall to continue growing the business. I was mowing, but we'd get to this time of the year and I wouldn't be able to bag anything. So I went ahead and bought the Toro time cutter with the bagger, and it wasn't the best, but it allowed me to still do cleanups through fall, which prolonged my season, made me able to do more money. And then what I did is I actually went and worked for a buddy, Kenny, and he owned Wallace Lawn Care at the time, and I plowed for him in the winter and made extra money, took pride, threw it out the window. I even did that when I was still on the channel. Those videos are from back in the day. Believe it or not, our one big commercial was an account for snow removal that I had subcontracted to Kenny. All of the Arby's that I had back in the day, I subcontracted those to Kenny for snow plowing. I think he was getting hit by dust here. Oh yeah, so here, let me point this out real quick. They finally blacktopped the road. And it is dusty, I'll tell you what. I was wondering what she stopped for. They dumped their blacktop off in the yard for us. Super nice of them. So anyways, I plowed for Kenny for, I don't even know, 3 or 4 years until we went back into snow removal ourselves. And we had a small stint in snow, had used equipment, Myers back in the day, and we financially just weren't ready to take on that risk. So I plowed for Kenny, made money, worked through the winter, got back to spring, went back at it hardcore with advertising, And that's how I continued growing Spencer Lawn Care. And it was just me at the time, and then bringing on employees. You know, we had Rocky back in the day, Sean back in the day, Ben, but they all had jobs as well. They were buddies from high school, and they were just looking to make extra money. They'd work for me a year or 2 years, whatever, and that was that, and that was cool. And I appreciate them very much. They helped out a ton in growing this thing. And we're gonna continue growing it, guys. I'm continually investing back into our company and into ourselves, and that's part of it. None of us were gifted with all of the answers, and a lot of times you got to make a lot of mistakes to get where you want to go. So if you're watching this, you got to take that pride, throw it out the window, like I said, get yourself a job, work as late into the season as you possibly can. And I'm saying, hey, you got to take on side jobs, get that done. Gutter clean outs, snow shoveling, whatever, guys. You got to get something to continue going. Now, hopefully you got enough in your nest egg that you can go through the entire winter and just kick back and chill. I know plenty of guys that do that. Like, literally the end of November, guys, they do not do anything for about 2 months before they start really working on their advertising, getting ready for spring. They don't do nothing in winter. They take it easy. They vacation. Now, they're not going out and buying Lamborghinis or, you know, $100,000 diesel pickup trucks. They probably could if they wanted to, but they're just not. So, yeah, that's what I want to share with you. Go do what you got to do to freaking get by. Don't listen to these gurus, I guess you can say, that make this stuff look easy. None of this crap is easy. Every bit of this is going to be hard. And that's what nobody wants to tell you. And it's going to have its great moments. It's going to have its horrible moments. Stripes, guys. I know earlier I stated I didn't know exactly which day it is. It's October 21st, Monday. Hey, I'll take it. Alright, these guys are waiting for us to get out of the way so they can work on this machine. So, packing it up quickly. Got it. All right. So that thing's not running, so I don't know if it needs some work or what. If you remember, it's normally really, really loud. You couldn't even hear us right now if that thing was running. So I'm guessing that's what they're going up to work on. Anyways. On out of here. We were unable to mow the little piece over here because they brought a bunch of skids out here and set them. The road's really nice, but
the lawn was dusty.
Oh yeah.
Oh my goodness.
The flags are just getting added to, so they're like, I don't know, they got more and more people plugging them in the yard. So, you know, the old flowers we love.
Oh